More than life itself, Paul, we love doing the little skits.
I was inspired by Kevin Klein, and I just put a little bit more Shakespearean
acting
into it.
Fantastic job.
I don't know why.
Our next guest is certainly an old friend and quite a favorite of ours here on this program. I have a copy of her newest album. Number what? 23? 23? You don't know. You quit counting?
No?
Okay. Anyway, it's called Emmylou Harris and the Nash Ramblers at the Ryman. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome her back to our program, the one, the only Emmylou Harris. Kids! That's a great song. That's I was looking it up here, of course, John Fogerty.
Yeah,
and then I start looking at some of the other songs, and you got Bill Monroe and many, many other people writing, yeah. Or you're doing great songs that they have written. Now, is that more fun for you, as much fun for you, or about the same as when you do your own songs for an album?
Well, see, the problem is that to do your own songs, you have to write them.
Yeah.
That's not fun.
So it's, but this sounds terrific, this Lodi.
Thank you. Very nice job.
Well,
the album is an album of covers, and covers that are mostly recognizable. That was some kind of a theme I had running in my head for doing the album.
And the theme for this one is
songs that other people have done.
There you
done
go.
By me.
These music people don't miss a beat, do they?
No. Hopefully not.
Well, I want to thank you. You're going to be on our big 10th anniversary show in a couple
weeks.
Thank
I'm
you
really
very much.
I
appreciate
that.
Your participation in that. We're really looking forward to it. Now, when you were here before, you didn't have. This is acoustic, right? You're working mostly acoustic now.
Well, my touring band, the Nash Ramblers, are all acoustic.
Right.
And when we were touring this summer, we came to town to play the Beacon Theater, but it got canceled, so we went to the ball game instead.
Hey, good gig. But why was it canceled at the Beacon Theater?
Well, you have to ask them. I don't know. But anyway, we had a good time at seeing the Mets.
No, wait a minute. I'm concerned about this. You roll into town. Mm. You've got a gig at the Beacon Theater. You show up, and they say, I'm going to be sure. Go to the ball game. We'll see you tomorrow.
We got to do your show.
Yeah, we were happy to have you here.
It was all worthwhile.
But have you changed bands? Has the concept of the band changed?
Oh, yeah. It's a completely all-acoustic band. And
yeah.
We've been together. It'll be 2 years in April.
Right. And why did you change?
Well, I was having trouble singing over top of the loud instruments night after night.
So you fired them.
I fired those those guys. No, we had been together for a long time, 14 years,
yeah.
And it was time to make a change to get the creative juices flowing again and try put an element of terror in it, the element of the unknown,
yeah.
You know, and see what came up. And I'm just so pleased with the change.
Well, it sounds terrific. Yeah. And we couldn't, again, be happier to have you with us on the big anniversary program.
Oh,
so while you're in town, try and take in a Knicks game.
I wish I had time.
All right. Good to see you.
I wish I had time.
Thanks again. Emmylou Harris, kids. We'll be right back with the man who invented...